Thank you. particularly difficult because if you ever try playing on Zoom, it don't work. Right? If I went ahead and said, okay, band, one, two, three, four, boom, I would have gotten from this group, one, two, three, four, put the papa, the bitty papa. Someone had a really bad leg. Right? And so we were not able to go ahead and get to do this for basically the better part of 2 years. Right? And we are very, very excited to be back this way. I will say we had some great help from some folks to keep us going, not just the concert band, but the whole music ensembles here at San Barbara City College. If you're not aware, our jazz bands were able to rehearse thanks to an innovative program called Jamulus, thanks to my friend and dear colleague up there, Professor James Moore. But our groups are too large, his symphony and my concert band are too large to be able to do that. And so I don't know if you've had a chance, but we actually made a virtual year for those two groups and actually uploaded images of everybody's part. And everyone downloaded and played. And I actually had a video uploaded of me conducting no one. That is weird. And everybody sent in, they recorded on their phones and sent in just their part. And these were all assembled. And actually, it takes an incredible amount of time. We've, I think, put out about 16, 17 of these pieces so far. And we're not done yet. We're that far backlog. They still take that much. But the person who did all this assembly, I want to give special recognition to, and that is Mr. Richard Gonzalez. And so we still have new things coming out for you from last year, and here we are doing a new concert. But it's absolutely exciting to be able to be back and in front of you. It's still a little weird. This is only since this week have we been able to rehearse without masks. In the band room, we have had not only masks on with little holes cut into them for our mouthpieces. You're laughing, but that's what we have. And bell covers over our instruments, and of course, right, all the other protocols that are in place. And yes, I'm even wristbanded tonight, too. Right? So it's been a little different, but it is nothing beats the ability of being back here live in front of you and having you here with us. It means so much to us. So thank you for being here tonight. So, you're probably wondering about this thing, right? For those of you who do not know, this is a marimba. Looks like a kind of a large xylophone, and it's played in a similar way. It's got a little deeper sound to it, right? And one of the early casualties we had art-wise for our programs, this is the concert that never was. We were in the middle of a season. Last spring of 2020, we were combining our concert band, which, you know, we're not as big yet, we're getting back into shape. We usually have like 90-something people on this stage, you know. And we were combining with the City College Concert Choir. And we were going to premiere a huge brand new symphony based off of J.R.R. Tolkien's novels. We were going to have soprano soloists singing in Elvish. We were going to have male choir members grunting in Orcish, banging rocks together. We can't do that. All that went down. Now, I hope someday we get to bring that back with you once things are more back to normal. But one piece that we were going to do on the concert that never was a concerto for the marimba. And that does not require a choir. So we are very happy to bring this one to you. And our soloist tonight, I've known for several years now, coming through as a music major here at City College, and also working with all three of our local high school marching bands and drum lines. In fact, he just got back yesterday from the marching band championships with Santa Barbara High School. For the first time in 12 years, not only did Santa Barbara High School make the championships, they came back with a very respectable 7th place for the entire school. Levara Kawite. Would you please?
Thank you.
Is known as a programmatic appreciation students in the audience furiously taking notes for your class, right? You know, some of which are my students, right? You know that programmatic music means we're going to be telling you a story, giving you images in this case, and that's what this is right here. This next piece called The Witch and the Saint actually is based off of a German novel and translates to Die Hexe und die Heilige, right? And this is a tale of two identical twin sisters born back in 1588. And back in 1588, according to this tale, right, identical twins were bad luck. They had special powers that they shouldn't have. Right? And so, one of these young girls was sent off to a convent to become a nun. It's the saint. And the other one, sure enough, grew up to be the evil twin and wreaked havoc on the town. And so you're going to hear these different sections being presented back and forth. The end of our tale, you'll notice that we end rather somberly here, because what happens at the end of our fairy tale here is the saint sister comes back to try and rescue her sister from the townsfolk, you know, pitches, the torches and pitchforks, as they say, right? And they get both of them, and the saint sister actually takes poison, and the evil sister actually escapes. And so you will hear a very somber ending to this tale. So here is The Witch and the Saint. Thank you. one here is called Hanover Festival. Hope you enjoy. Woo.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. This next piece is another one of these programmatic works for us, and it's called Mont Blanc, which of course is the famous mountain in the Alps. And so we're going to take you on sort of a climbing expedition here at Mont Blanc. For those of you who've heard other pieces similar in this style, like, for example, The Moldau by Smetana, a very famous one where you picture yourself going down a river and you're seeing all these beautiful sights along the way, right? This is a very similar one. We're going to be ascending it. You're going to be hearing the 4 o'clock a.m. Wake-up call because we have to start up the mountain early and the birds are coming out and everything. You're going to be hearing a big snowstorm in here with some thunder and lightning going on. The final trudge up the ascent and making it up to the top. So you can picture this one. This is almost one you can close your eyes, although they're really fun to watch, aren't they?
Yeah.
Some of you just come out just to watch the percussion run around. Yeah. We very much appreciate that. But this is Mont Blanc.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Sawyer suite of ours, right? This is another piece where we're going to be hearing themes in sort of a similar way as to what you would picture if you know like Wagner operas and things, or actually if you know Star Wars. Every character's got a theme, right? Luke Skywalker's got a theme, Princess Leia's got a theme, Yoda's got a theme, etc. Well, we're going to have each movement show themes, melodies, right? So the first movement, Tom Sawyer himself will have a theme. The second movement, Huckleberry Finn will have his own theme, and you'll actually hear another melody coming in that's an old folk song called Ring Ring the Banjo. The third movement is Becky Thatcher, the sweet girl of Tom's dreams. And then we will close off the final movement with putting all those themes against each other at the same time, different combinations, it's really neat. I do want to point out, if you notice, in the program, the movements are listed 1, 2, 3, 5. That is not a typo. Unfortunately, the fourth movement has some issues, I will say that. And us a live audience to play for. We very, very much appreciate that. And by the way, if you're not aware, we're doing something new, and my colleague, Professor Nui back there, is actually helping us make this happen. For the first time, this concert is being live streamed on YouTube. So there's actually, if you go, all of our major concerts this semester, we are going ahead and doing that. So we've already done this with our jazz concert on Monday, this one as well. We have two other big ones coming up, not this next weekend, because that's Thanksgiving weekend, we take that off. But the Saturday after that, which is December the 4th, we're going to have our choir concert being broadcast from First United Methodist Church. That will also have our trombone choir on as well. And Sunday, December 5th, Professor Mui's City College Symphony Orchestra, with the New World Symphony by Dvorak. Oh, no. And also, Cody Anderson. Cody, actually, during our virtual year, composed two entire suites for the City College Symphony. Actually, we are going to hear one finally live outside of the Zoom version with the recording, like we talked about. We're going to be having it on stage, so check that out. All these, by the way, they'll be live streaming, and that same YouTube link will actually let you see it anytime you want. We're going to stay up forever and ever and ever that way. If you're going to try and find the link, the simplest way is simply go to YouTube and type in SBCC Music Department, and you'll find all the links to all those concerts right there. SBCC Music Department, right on YouTube. All gotten very used to computers and all that over these last couple of semesters, certainly. We are going to be doing, though, one more live event with our, well, not everybody in the concert band, but our brass players. And that is, for those of you who know about it, our big Christmas brass extravaganza we do. That's going to be Saturday, December 11th. And that's going to be at 12 noon at a place called Stork Placita. That's the 700 block of State Street. You know, between Delagara Plaza and State, there's a nice open courtyard there called Stork Placita on the 700 block of State. That's Saturday, December 11th. We'd love to have you come on out. It's absolutely free. It's outdoors. And we'll even have chairs for you as well on that one. And if you are a brass player or you know a brass player who'd like to join us, we'll make the core group on that, but we're asking anyone, even elementary, junior high, high school, other colleges, community members, come on out. We rehearse here outdoors. We'll be this time outside of our band room at 9 a.m. that same day. We'll get all the music, and we'll go and play that concert for you at 12 noon. So come on out. It's absolutely free on that one. We hope you join us December 11th. So speaking of the holidays, of course, if you've come to our concerts in the past, you know that we always love to finish with a holiday tune. Especially, I love to get to do holiday medleys. And that's what I have for you, except it's kind of weird. If you're looking at the title of the last piece here in your program called Minor Alterations, these are all your favorite Christmas carols that should be in major keys. They're all in minor keys. It's kind of creepy and sort of a Nightmare Before Christmas sort of way. Get a definite Danny Elfman kind of vibe from this one. See how many of the Christmas tunes you can recognize, but don't sing along because you'll make it too bad. So I hope you enjoy this one, Minor Alterations. Thank you.
right now.